Soul. according to St. John.
Almost 70 years ago, having lived as a
Christian almost 20, Robert Taft came to his house. He prayed in this chapel for years at the beginning of his Jesuit mission and at its end. In the beauty of this house, surrounded by the incredible beauty of New England's nature. Having been given life by a life-giving family, brothers, sisters, cousins, with time, nieces and nephews. His path back in New York, in Rome, in so many other countries on different continents, was guided by this mission. To love God and love neighbor. To serve the church. To help people pray. His scholarship was daunting, as often was his person. It was guided by that search for truth, a purging, lightning, enlightening, inspiring truth. We hear it today in the hymns. Yes, we will all die. It's the one sure thing in this life. But do we believe that we're called to eternity? Because if we do, it changes everything. That which is catastrophe, utter darkness, the pit. For those who do not believe, for those baptized and clothed in Christ, is a passage. Not easy, sometimes tormenting, painful. But it's a step into the eternity of God's home. All of Bob's life was guided by this faith and this vision. All of Bob's life was guided by the desire to share this with people. To help people see it clearly, experience, sing, preach it, engrave it on one's heart. Bob Taft was a piece of work. I was humbled a few years ago when he wrote me and asked me to be here today. He knew he couldn't control everything, but he wanted to control as much as he could. Who's serving? Who's singing? And allow me to speak in his name. To you and through you to all the people that may want to hear. I thank you, members of my family. I thank you, Brother Jesuits, of the Wall. priests called missionaries, who had the fortune to share this house as a novice, as a scholastic, with whom I shared the last 6 years. I thank you. I thank the colleagues and students, the editors, publishers. Thank Sister Vasa, who was particularly close. I thank all of you that were part of my life. They gave me light, joy, companionship around the altar and around the table of friendship. At the same time, allow me to say I'm sorry. God gave me a sharp knife and an articulate tongue. Sometimes I switch those around. For anybody that I have cut or hurt or bruised, I ask forgiveness. Because I wanted to always be true to this mission. To witness the love of God for every human being. It was moving to see Bob Taft as he sent off a note to a friend whose mother or father had died. Many of us received those notes. It was moving to hear the testimony, witness of a student who recounted a husband visiting by Bob. How heartening it was to see a scholar who took such great interest in the writing, publishing, career of his students. Bob endorsed the role of the lady in the church. He put forth women. He challenged bishops, cardinals, and popes. Always mindful of his vows of obedience. I think every Eastern Catholic and Eastern Orthodox Church today is a prayer of gratitude to the Lord for the life of Archimandrite Robert. I share with the family and all of you condolences of the head of the Ukrainian Catholic Church, his Beatitudes of the Song, who as a student came to know Bob. The nuncio in Ukraine, Claudio Bujarotti, who was his student. And add to that the words, the prayers, the condolences of so many bishops, priests, religious, and lady whose life was enriched by his service. Bob had a profound sense of the church. He knew that it's not just a structure and institution, but it is the body of Christ, which cannot be divided. And when we do so, we're off that mission. So much of his time and effort was spent to bring Christians together. He wore two crosses. Some say he was double crossed. One is Archimandrite in the Greek Catholic Church, one from the Slovak Church from originally. One is Archimandrite of Catholics, but also one from the Ecumenical Patriarch of Constantinople. I don't know of anybody else that was in such a man of honor. He sought to clarify those misunderstandings that keep us apart. And so we pray with him and for him, with his communities and for his communities, that all his sins may be forgiven. We pray because we're one church. The kingdom is already here. Bob is entering the one that is to come here. It's paradoxical. There's antinomy. It's not either or. It's both and. We pray also to remember ourselves, who we are and what our mission is. You and I and all of us are created in love and sent in love to complete our mission, to preach the truth, to give life, to create unity, to inspire and to liberate, and then to be called home. May the last sermon of Archimandrite Robert give you peace and joy. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. We will proceed now to a very moving rite, the opportunity for all here present to say goodbye. In the Byzantine liturgy, which Bob explained to the world, it's called the last kiss, during which all who so desire come up to the body, bid farewell, and then proceed forward to kiss the cross, receive consolation, which the cross brings as a sign of Christ's victory over our death.
Oh. Let us ask of Christ, the immortal King and Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
O souls, O glorious Lord,
slain by the Lord.
O spirits of flesh, you trampled death, you made forgive every sin of heart, word.
Our Lord Jesus Christ, by his divine grace, and also by the gift and power granted to his holy disciples and apostles, that they should bind and loose the sins of men, for he said to them, receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven them. And if you retain the sins of any, they are retained. And whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven, whatever you loose on earth will be loosed in heaven. By that same power transmitted to us from them, this my spiritual child, Archimandrite Robert, is absolved in me, unworthy though I be, from all things, by which, being mortal, he has sinned against God, whether in word or deed or thought, and with all his senses, whether voluntary or involuntary, whether knowingly or through ignorance. If he be under the ban of excommunication of a bishop or priest, or has incurred the curse of his father or mother, has fallen under his own curse, or has sinned in any oath, or has been bound as man by any sins whatsoever, but has repented of these with contrition of heart, he is now absolved from all these faults and bonds. May all those things which have proceeded from the weakness of his mortal nature be consigned to oblivion and be forgiven him, through his loving kindness, through the prayers of our most holy, blessed, and glorious Sovereign Lady, the Mother of our Lord and ever Virgin Mary, of the holy, glorious, and all praiseworthy apostles, and of all the saints.
Thank you.
This is the Lord's.
The earth is the Lord and the fullness thereof, the world and all who live in it.
Earth and dust and ashes is what you are, O man, and therefore, according to the will of God, you return to the earth once again. This grave is sealed until the second coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Upon my grave, call to mind my love for you, and pray to Christ to place my soul among the just.
Have mercy on us, O God, in the greatness of your compassion. We pray you, hear us and have mercy. We also pray for the repose of the soul of the servant of God, the Archimandrite Robert, newly departed this life, that he may be pardoned all of his transgressions, voluntary and involuntary. Establish his soul where all the Jews repose. The mercies of God, the kingdom of heaven, and the remission of his sins, let us ask of Christ, the immortal King and God.
For you, O Christ, our God, are the resurrection, the life, and the repose of your servant, the Archimandrite Robert, who has fallen asleep. And we give glory to you, together with your eternal Father, and your most holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Wisdom,
honorable than the cherubim, and by far more glorious than the seraphim, ever a virgin you gave birth to God the Word, O true Mother of all we granted by you.
Glory be to you, O Christ our God, our hope. Glory be to you.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and forever, and from ages. Amen. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Master,
rise up to God, risen from the dead, who has power over the living and the dead, through the praise of his Immaculate Mother, of the holy, glorious, and all praiseworthy apostles, of our venerable and godly fathers, of our venerable Father Ignatius of Loyola, and of all the saints, who will place the souls of his servant, the Archimandrite Robert, which has departed from us, in the bosom of the just, and will give him rest in the bosom of Abraham, and number him among the just, and will have mercy on us, for he is good and loves mankind.
Amen. In blessed repose, grant, O Lord, eternal rest to the soul of your ever-to-be-remembered servant, the Archimandrite Robert, and make his memory eternal.
Krishnaya Namah. my brethren and fellow ministers, do not forget me when you pray, but looking upon my grave, call to mind my love for you, and pray to Christ to place my soul among the just.